CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. Let's join in Dhwani Shala class 4.
Hello children, how are you all? I know you all are very smart and must be doing fine. And I know you are very wise too. So please stay safe, stay healthy and do not go out unnecessarily. You know what we are going to do today? Today we'll study chapter 2, long and short. And today's episode we are going to discuss how long or how high a thing can be in comparison to another. And you know children, when I came to the studio for recording, I was wearing the mask all the time and following the rules of social distancing. So you also need to follow all the protocol of hand washing, regularly maintaining social distancing and wearing a mask. Okay, that way you can stay safe and you can stay healthy and you can help us in containing the spread of the pandemic. Okay, so let's see how high a thing can be in comparison to other objects, or how high or short or long or short a thing can be when we are comparing two or more objects. I know, you have already studied a part of this topic already in the previous session. Yes, in the previous session, you have estimated the length of various things. And yes, you have also guessed the length and then actually measured the length with the scale or measuring tape. And yes, you have also measured your fingers, your pencil boxes, the length of the pencil, the length of the eraser, all the things that you could lay your hands on. You have measured the length of all these things. And I hope you found all this interesting. Have you measured your own height? If not, please do that. Measuring your own height and measuring the height of your family members will be really an interesting activity. You can line them up and measure their height, and then you can see which family member is the tallest and who is having the short height. Okay, so let's start today's class. Before starting the today's class, let me share an incident with you. You know children, I visited a mela before the pandemic. And in the mela, as you are aware, there used to be many stalls which sells various items. So in this mela, I found one particular corner of the mela overcrowded. So much so, the children were fighting with each other, almost on the verge of fighting. I could not contain my curiosity and went to find out why there were so many children gathered at this particular corner of the mela. You know what I found? I found at this particular corner of the mela, there were many swings. Swings like merry-go-round, toy trains, toy cars, and you know, toy bikes were also there. Everybody was so excited. They wanted to enjoy every ride. So the children were gathered in this part along with their parents so that they can enjoy the rides. And you know, there was one ride on which it was mentioned that children below the height of 4 meter could not take this ride. There was one child whose name was Vikas who was standing near this ride. His height was 345 centimeters. Now, can you tell me, will he be able to enjoy this particular ride? Think carefully. What was the instructions? Instructions was, children below the height of 4 meter will not be allowed to take the ride. And the height of this child named Vikas was 345 centimeters. So how you're going to solve this riddle? It's very simple and you're very smart. You are aware that in a meter there are how many centimeters? 100 centimeters. So 4 meter converted into centimeter is 400 centimeters. In other words, I can say 4 meter is equal to 400 centimeter. So who all will be able to take this right? All those children whose height is above 400 centimeters. Yes. And what was the height of Vikas? Vikas' height was only 345 centimeters, which is less than 400 centimeters. That means he is less than 4 meters in height. So Vikas is not allowed to take this ride. And you know, there is another child who seems to be friend of Vikas, because both were holding hands and standing together. Ravi had a height of 409 centimeters. Now tell me, will Ravi be able to enjoy the ride? 409 centimeter. And the instruction says children below 4 meter are not allowed. Okay. So now 409 centimeter is more than 4 meters. So yes, Ravi will be able to enjoy this ride. But now since Ravi and Vikas were friends, so Ravi said, it's okay. I'm allowed to enjoy this ride, but I'm not going to take this ride because Vikas is not allowed. Okay. How good friends they were. Now, each one of you, can you tell me whether you will be able to enjoy this ride? What you have to do to find out? You have to measure your height in meters and then you have to convert it into centimeters or in meters if it is coming out to be more than 4 meter or 4 meter, you will be able to enjoy this particular ride. And you know, kids, in this Mela, there was another ride. And the criteria for this ride was children above the height of 4.5 meter, they will not be able to ride. Now 4 meter and 0.5 meter. Now let's see whether Vikas and Ravi will be able to take this ride or not. So what will be? Okay. You know how many centimeters are there in 4.5 meters? Yes, we already know that 4 meters is equal to 400 centimeters and 0.5 meter will have 50 centimeters. So 4 meter and 0.5 meter will be 450 centimeters. And in this ride, children above 450 centimeters are not allowed to take the ride. So let's see, Vikas has a height less than 400 centimeters. And Ravi had a height which is slightly more than 400 centimeters. But if you look carefully, their heights is less than 450 centimeters. So both Ravi and Vikas will be able to enjoy this particular ride on which children above the height of 4.5 meters are not allowed. So they both had a very big smile on their faces. And you know, in this particular ride, there was another child who was standing in the line. And this child's height was 485 centimeters. And he was crying badly because he wanted to enjoy this particular ride. Do you think he will be allowed to take this ride? Think. You know, the height of this kid was 485 centimeter, and we have just now seen that 4 meter and 0.5 meter is nothing but 450 centimeters, and this child's height is much more than 450 centimeter. So this child will not be allowed to enjoy this particular ride. Yes, I know many of you might have calculated it. You're very smart and much faster than me in calculations also. Okay, now let's see another case in this Mela only. There is another child, a girl, whose height is 4 meters and 10 centimeters. And she is, you know, tagging. She's literally begging the gatekeeper to allow her to take this ride. Tell me, should the gatekeeper allow this girl to enjoy this ride? What do you say? The allowed height was 4 meter and half meter. 4 meter is equal to 400 centimeters. And half meter is equal to 50 centimeters. So total height allowed is 450 centimeters. And this girl's height is 4 meter and 10 centimeters. When you convert it into centimeters, it will be nothing but 410 centimeters, which is less than 450 centimeters. So this girl is allowed to enjoy this particular ride. Yeah, I know. Many of you are genius. You have calculated it much before me. Okay. Now, shall I take one more example? Yes. So, you all are excited to solve this riddle also? Fine. Okay. Now, before I share this example, stand up from wherever you are sitting and take a jump. Take a very long jump. As long as you can. Take a long jump. Okay, after the jump, now you may sit down. You know why I ask you to take this jump? Because I'm going to take the example of Mike Powell. You know who is Mike Powell? Mike Powell holds the record for men's long jump. He jumped 8 meter 95 centimeters. And yes, he's not an Indian. And you know, an Indian, Sri Shankar Murali, he holds the Indian record for men's long jump. And he jumped 8 meters 20 centimeters. Now, can you tell me how many centimeters more should Sri Shankar jump to equal the record of Mike Powell's long jump? Yes. Do it. Okay, let me do it with you. World record is for 8 meters, 95 centimeters. That is by Mike Powell. I just told you. Sri Shankar jumped 8 meter, 20 centimeters. So in these, 8 meter is common. So we'll have to now compare 95 centimeter and 20 centimeters. And you know, yes, 95 centimeter is obviously more than 20 centimeters. And when you subtract 20 centimeters from 95 centimeters, yes, the number is 75 centimeters. So Sri Shankar had to improve his long jump by 75 centimeters to make it equal to the world record. And if he wants to break the world record, he has to jump more than 8 meter and 95 centimeters. Right? Yes, you all are genius. Now, connected to this, there is another question. You have to find out how many more centimeters Sri Shankar should jump to reach 9 meters. This you can solve later on with the help of your friends or brother or sister, or yes, you can solve it on your own also. Now, since we have talked about men's long jump record, I know all my little girls sitting and listening to me must be thinking about women's long jump record. Yes, there is a woman called Galina. She holds the world record for women's long jump. And you know, she jumped 7 meters 52 centimeters. A little shorter than the men's record, but quite impressive, yes? Now it is 7 meters 52 centimeters. Now can you tell me, it is more than 7.5 meters or less than 7.5 meters? Do you finding it tricky? No, it's not tricky. Let's see. She jumped 7 meters 52 centimeters. And I am asking you whether it is more than or less than 7 meters and a half meter. So 7 meter is common in both the figures. We have to find out now whether 52 centimeters is more than or less than half a meter. Yes, you all remember that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So half a meter will be equal to 50 centimeters. In this way, 52 centimeters is slightly more than half a meter. So Galina jumped little more than 7 meters and half meter. Yes, all those who have got the answers right, they are smiling. I know you are very smart. And you know, Indian record holder for women's long jump is Anju Bobby George. She jumped 6 meter 83 centimeters. 6 meter 83 centimeters. Yes. Now who is going to tell me how much shorter she is from 7 meters? By how many centimeters? Not very difficult. You just have to pay a little attention. She jumped 6 meters 83 centimeters. Now, in order to reach 7 meters, we have to add some centimeters to 83 centimeters. Why? Because we have to convert 83 centimeters. We have to make 83 centimeters to 100 centimeters so that it becomes 1 meter. So, how much short is 83 centimeters from 100 centimeters? Let me calculate it. How do I do it? I have to subtract 83 from 100 and I am getting a number 17. So Anju Bobby George has to improve her long jump by only 17 centimeters to complete her 7 meters. You can clap for yourself. Yes, all those who are smiling and all those who are struggling to do the calculations, don't worry. You'll become master after some repetitions or some more practice. Okay. Now imagine you are studying in a school and your school has... Now why to imagine that you are studying in a school? All of you are studying in a school. Yes. But let's imagine your school has a circular running track. This circular running track is 250 meters long. And the PT teacher, the physical education teacher, has advised Reena to run 1 kilometer daily. Now Reena is confused how many rounds of the track she should take to complete 1 kilometer. Think of a way to help her out. The length of the track is 250 meters. Sir has advised Reena to run 1 kilometer. Now, how do I go about solving this? Oh, yes, I know. Many of you are jumping on your seats. You know, for solving this, what you have to do is you have to find relation between meter and kilometer. 1 kilometer has how many meters? 1000 meters. All those who are smiling, yes, this I know you are aware of. And all those who are not aware of, just remember, 1 kilometer has 1000 meters. So, if sir has asked Reena to run for 1000 meters, that is 1 kilometer, and the track has length of only 250 meters, so how many rounds Reena has to take to complete 1 kilometer? Now, this seems a little easier. So, one round on track is 250 meters. So if Reena takes 2 rounds, she will complete how many meters? 250 plus 250 is 500 meters. And if Reena is taking 3rd round, let's add further 250 to this 500 meters and we will arrive at the number 750 meters. So in 3 rounds, Reena will complete 750 meters. And if you'll add another round, that is the 4th round of the track, you will reach a number 1000 meters. So, how many rounds Reena has to run? 4 rounds of the track. That will make 1 kilometer. Okay. Now, suppose Reena's brother says, I am much stronger than you and I want to complete 2 kilometers. So, how many rounds he will have to take? To complete 1 kilometer, Reena had to take 4 rounds. And if his brother wants to show her that he is able to do running for 2 kilometers, he'll have to take double the rounds that Reena has taken. And these are 4 plus 4, that is 8 rounds. Okay. Now children, let me take another example. And this time, the example is one of our ancient monument. And this monument is located in Delhi, the capital of India. The name of this monument is Qutub Minar. And you know the height of Qutub Minar? It is 72 meters. Yes, the Qutub Minar is 72 meters. Now, can you estimate what is the height of your room? The height of your room will be, let's say, much more than the height of your father, much more than the height of your mother. On an average, the height of any room is around 3 meters. Okay. So, if we put 10 such rooms on one above the other, we will reach 30 meters. 30 meters. 10 rooms on top of the other. Okay. So, we have 10 stories. Now, the height of the Qutub Minar was 72 meters. So, how many more rooms we will require? How many more stories on top? Let's see. By having 10 stories, we just reached 30 meters. Add 10 more. So, we will get height of 60 meters. Just double the 30. Okay. Now, 60 meters, still we are short of the height of the Qutub Minar. Qutub Minar's height is 72 meters. So, subtract 60 from 72. So, we still need to cover 12 meters. And if height of one room is 3 meters, so we'll still need to add 4 more rooms. Now, can you imagine how high is the Qutub Minar? It will take around 24 rooms, one on top of the other. That will be the height of Qutub Minar. That means 24 stories, one over the other. Children, can you guess how far is your school from your home? You may say, I take around 5 minutes walk to reach my school. Someone will say, I have to ride, say, around 15 minutes to reach my school from my house. Let me tell you about a child called Momun. You know how Momun reaches her school? Momun had to walk 400 meters. Then 150 meters she walks through the pond. And then 350 meters she runs continuously. And for next 40 meters she has to walk very carefully because it's a wide road. This is how she reaches school every day. Can you tell me how much distance Momun travels every day to reach school from her house? Okay. Yes. Let me read it out once again. She walks 400 meters, then 150 meters through pond, then 350 meters she runs and crosses 40 meters wide road. So let's add 400 plus 150 plus 350 plus 40. How much you're getting? Do I hear someone saying 760 meters? No, you're wrong. Do your calculations again. Yes, the correct answer is 940 meters. Momun had to walk 940 meters daily to reach school. And you know, 940 meters is quite close to 1000 meters. So it is little less than 1 kilometer because 1 kilometer has 1,000 meters. Okay, so Momun had to travel quite a lot of distance to reach her school. I hope you are enjoying learning mathematics through radio, through audio mode. Now, it is time for me to give you some homework, right? Don't make faces. I'm not going to give you very difficult homeworks. So be ready with your pen and paper. Yes, and start writing the first question. Children, your question number one is, you'll have to take a reel. You know what is a reel? A reel is a small object on which lot of thread is wound around. Okay. Now you have to take this reel and estimate what would be the length of thread. Will it be more than 1 kilometer or will it be less than 1 kilometer? Isn't it interesting? Yes. Now write down the second question. All of you must have enjoyed flying kite, right? Yes. Now can you tell me, if you are flying a kite, then can your kite fly higher than the Qutub Minar? What was the height of the Qutub Minar? I told you, 72 meters. So think, can your kite go higher than the Qutub Minar? That is 72 meters. Interesting, right? The third question. What you have to do in the third question is, draw a line on the floor. But wait, for drawing this line, you don't have to use scale or any measuring instrument. Just draw a line on the floor and then see whether it is equal to 1 meter or less than 1 meter or more than 1 meter. You know, the task is to draw a line of 1 meter. Okay, interesting. All these three questions. Now, the last question. Last question is also related to the daily life activity. And you can do it easily at home. After drawing a line of 1 meter, you have to draw a line of 2 meter without using any instrument and then measure it. So this is all, children. Today, we have learned about the height of objects and compared heights with one another. So children, stay safe, stay happy, stay indoors, wash your hands regularly and wear mask if you're going outside. Thank you.
Friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistant, Amit Kumar. This series Dhwani Shala was recorded by Bati Langlingdo and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Vimlesh Chaudhary. And this program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.